Right, guys, Jonathan here. Right, on the way into Aberystwyth now. I'm going to go, hopefully, and say hello to the guys in Backbeat Records and show you a nice little record shop in the middle of Aberystwyth. A bit of bad news, and that is that, as you know, there's that guy called Victor Vett, and I spoke to him a while ago, and apparently the badger he looked at died. So it's a bit of a shame, actually. The actual vet did try and sort of help him, but he, you know, he realised afterwards, a bit thick, that vet, that there wasn't much hope. And mind you, the vet, you know, is a very sensible chap because he got the plaster back and scraped off the ointment from the actual badger's tummy. Anyway, right, on the way into Aberystwyth now, and we shall go and see a few people. Speak to you soon. Right, I'd like to show you this as well. This is a new bit of road they've done just before Tledrod. And as you can see in the hedge there, if I slow down, you can see two rather nice holes. And I think what's happening now is people are going to start using that as a car park. This particular piece of road just before Tledrod, yes, they've widened it, but they've basically made it into a death trap on that corner because people go very fast around there now. Right, just outside Backbeat Records. Let's go and check it out. All right, dude.
All right, that's good.
So, what can you tell me about this place then?
It's been going over 4 years. It's started by a guy called Clive. I've been involved with it since 6 months ago.
Cool.
And sell records and DJ equipment.
Nice one. Well, there you go. Now, this is what a proper record shop should have, and that is a set of turntables on the counter, and the DJ or whoever can come along, not necessarily batter them to hell, but at least in this shop, like quite a few, but there are a few shops that won't let you. You can come in and actually play the music that you want to buy, as opposed to coming in and looking at a record and thinking that looks good, taking it home and thinking you've bought a bag of shit. So at least you can play the stuff here. But yeah, I like this place simply because it's not just top 40 stuff or the latest house tracks. You've got absolutely everything here. I mean, you know, all right, some people don't like Van Halen, but then at the end of the day, there are a lot of people that actually do like Van Halen. And I personally like this man here, Mr. Stevie Wonder. It's pretty cool. And also, it's nice to see a record shop that sells DJ gear, which is pretty cool. Let's have a look what else they've got here. See, what you want to do now is have a look at these record covers, and if you've got any, you can leave a comment underneath saying, I've got that. In fact, I've got that. Good track on that, Looking Through the Front Door. I think it's called that, something like that, isn't it? And then some setups. There you go. That's a direct. How much was that setup again? 275 quid for a direct drive turntable setup, and that's with your headphones as well, isn't it? Yeah, that's not bad actually. I mean, at the end of the day, I'll be honest with you, you know, they're not as good as Technics, but then again, a Technics turntable will cost you 300 quid. You can buy all that for the same amount. It's not bad. And there you go, and this is what I like. Right, check this out. This is pretty cool. Oh shit. Hold on. It's alright, it didn't fall on the floor, but look at that. There you go. That is for the DJ who wants to be posh. That's pretty cool, that.
This is Dramatic Twins in Pembroke Pond.
folks. Now then, look at this. Check this out. Alright, it's basically two pieces of vinyl, and all you've got on it is just beats and some rather nice lady counting. So I'll give you a demo. Right, here we go. This is what it looks like. And if we play it, you can hear that. And then if we put the other one on. So the idea is basically just to match them up. Now if you can see there, you can see like a sort of a wave effect on the record. Now, one thing to notice with that is if you want to know if your record's been actually edited, if I stop that, if you watch and look at that wave, if that is a continual smooth wave, then basically it's perfectly in beat, perfectly in time. But if ever you can see that wave, sort of, it's almost like it's broken and it starts again, that means there's an edit there. So at that particular point, the beat could be off by a fraction, and I mean a fraction of a second, and if you've got it perfectly beat matched, it could put you off. So these records don't have that, they're perfect in every single way. So what we'll do, we'll start this one off again, over there, and then we'll put this one at the beginning, and we'll mix them in. Right, this should be interesting. Right, let's get it at the beginning. Right. Now bearing in mind I'm holding the camera as well. Right, we're there. Remember what I said, what you're looking for is that phasing. You can almost hear the hand clap disappear, and that's when the one's cancelling the other one out. About there. So you've got that one. Make it interesting. You could have fun with this, couldn't you? Well, there you go. That's pretty cool.